Have you ever wondered if the Mississippi River could flow backward? Imagine the chaos if it did. The New Madrid earthquakes have a history of making waves with seismic shifts centered around the Mississippi River that have caused the river to momentarily run backward in the past. But the question is, can it happen again? We've all heard about California's famous San Andreas Fault, famous for causing numerous earthquakes in the state. But let's talk about the seismic zone that unleashed incredible earthquakes over 200 years ago. We'll journey back to the winter of 1811, 1812 in the southeastern United States. During this time, a series of powerful earthquakes struck the area, now known as the New Madrid earthquakes. These earthquakes were centered around the town of New Madrid in the Missouri Territory. They were so intense that they even caused the mighty Mississippi River to temporarily reverse its flow. Imagine the force needed to make a river as massive as the Mississippi flow backward. The New Madrid earthquakes were some of the strongest ever recorded in the continental United States. In fact, they rank as among the largest earthquakes to ever hit the eastern half of our nation. We're talking about earthquakes that were estimated to be around magnitude 8.0 on the Richter scale. To put this into perspective, the devastating 1906 San Francisco earthquake was only around magnitude 7.8. The New Madrid earthquakes released such immense forces that their tremors were felt across an astonishing area of over 1 million square miles. Imagine the ground violently shaking, huge cracks opening up, and the soil turning into something resembling quicksand through a process called liquefaction. Massive landslides dumped millions of tons of soil into the rivers. And if that wasn't dramatic enough, the powerful Mississippi River temporarily flowed upstream due to the intense seismic activity. These earthquakes of 1811, 1812 were a dramatic reminder of the Earth's incredible power and its ability to reshape the landscape in an instant. They left a lasting mark on the region and serve as a vivid example of nature's unpredictability and raw force. Now you might be thinking, the New Madrid seismic zone sounds like a geological nightmare, but that was over 200 years ago. Surely it's been dormant since then, right? Well, not exactly. Why? Because what went down over 200 years ago might not be as ancient history as you'd think. The thing is, the New Madrid faults, yeah, they've been chill compared to that crazy period back in 1811, 1812. But guess what? They're still very much awake and making their presence known. Now, this seismic zone isn't just some small patch on the map. Nope, it extends across parts of Arkansas, Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, and Tennessee. And here's the twist. It's not just sitting there quietly. Nope, it's still rumbling with these little to moderate quakes every now and then. It's like nature's reminder, tapping on our shoulders saying, "Hey, don't forget about me." Whereas experts have crunched the numbers, and what they found might make you raise an eyebrow or two. They're saying there's a solid 25-40% chance of a major earthquake, like magnitude 6.0, or even bigger, shaking things up in the New Madrid region in the next few decades. Now, imagine that, a quake of that size. It's not just a little hiccup. No, it's the kind of shakeup that could cause some serious damage, sending shockwaves across several states. So, while you might think the big one is something you'd only see in movies or hear about on the coastlines, think again. Because of the New Madrid seismic zone, it's like a ticking time bomb, just waiting for its moment to make a big entrance. And the thing is, it's been keeping busy since those crazy quakes rocked the region way back in 1811, 1812. Crazy, I know, right? Now you might be wondering, how do scientists piece together the incredible details and immense scale of something that happened over 200 years ago? Well, it's thanks to some careful geological detective work and survivor accounts from the time. We have writings and reports from people who experienced the New Madrid quakes firsthand. These eyewitness accounts describe the dramatic ground shaking, loud roaring noises, topographic changes to the landscape, and of course, the temporary reversal of the Mississippi River's flow. But there's also plenty of physical evidence that has helped geologists reconstruct the magnitude of these quakes for future disasters to come. Things like soil liquefaction, features preserved in the sediments and ground cracks that have turned into long troughs and scarps over time. Analysis of the liquefaction features, which occur when intense shaking causes water-saturated soil to lose its strength and behave like a liquid, provides key data on the power of the seismic waves and epicenter locations. Then you have the extensive landslide deposits that plunged into the rivers, dramatically altering the waterways' courses. Geologists have examined these deposits and sediment displacements to gauge the immense forces involved. By carefully studying all these clues from over 200 years ago, scientists have been able to stitch together a frightening picture of one of the greatest earthquake sequences to ever rock the eastern United States. All right, now it's time to discuss our main topic of the video, whether the mighty Mississippi River could flow backward once again. You see, over two centuries ago, the New Madrid seismic zone shook the world, causing a remarkable event. It temporarily reversed the flow of this iconic river. Now the burning question is, could history repeat itself with another massive earthquake in the same area? Believe it or not, the answer is a resounding yes. It's entirely possible. The circumstances that led to the river's backward flow back in 1811-1812 could easily happen again if another significant earthquake were to strike the New Madrid region. Let's break it down. The Mississippi's flow reversed due to a perfect storm of seismic activity. Soil liquefaction, which turned solid ground into something resembling quicksand, caused parts of the riverbed to move like a dancer in an earthquake-induced frenzy. But that's not all. Massive landslides crashed into the river, sending shockwaves through the water and creating temporary waves that moved against the current upstream. This phenomenon defied the laws of nature. As if that wasn't enough, the earth itself shifted, with sections of the river's course lifting and sinking as the faults beneath them moved. This altered the river's slope and direction, allowing upstream water to temporarily flow in reverse. Now I know what you might be thinking. A backward flowing Mississippi sounds like something out of a tall tale. But trust me, it's not just a wild fantasy. If another major earthquake, like a magnitude 8.0 or higher, rattles the New Madrid fault system again, we could very well witness a repeat of the chaos from over 200 years ago. The force involved would be more than enough to recreate that historical event. Back in 2023, research funded by TOCA2AKEQC is filling a gap in existing knowledge about the immediate impact of earthquakes on rivers, including how they might change course or flood as a result. Aaron McEwen, a PhD student at the University of Canterbury, hopes that this research will raise awareness about earthquake multi-hazards. McEwen noted that she discovered a gap in the current research regarding the interaction between faults and rivers. Most studies concentrate on the long-term consequences spanning from decades to thousands of years. Surprisingly, there's scarce investigation on how surface ruptures during earthquakes can promptly alter river channels, despite numerous instances worldwide. She emphasized the necessity of comprehending the immediate consequences of surface ruptures during earthquakes. Presently, the outcomes and potential alterations in flood hazards remain uncertain. The research also shows that flooding following fault rupture events may not always happen instantly. In areas with low river flow, initially, nothing may occur. But in the following days or weeks, the river could flood or change its course if river flow rates increase. So, there you have it. The possibility of the mighty Mississippi River flowing backward once more isn't just a figment of imagination. It's a real possibility. Nature has shown us in the past that when the earth shakes, anything can happen, even the reversal of one of America's greatest rivers. All right, I need everyone's full attention here. You see, the New Madrid seismic zone has been surprisingly calm for the past couple of centuries. However, what's crucial to understand is that beneath this apparent calm lies a geological time bomb waiting to erupt once more. And if it does, the repercussions could be absolutely devastating. Imagine widespread damage across several states, buildings collapsing, infrastructure shattered, fires raging, countless injuries, and tragic loss of life. The human and economic toll would be catastrophic beyond measure. That's precisely why emergency planners and disaster agencies are laser-focused on preparing for the next big earthquake in the central United States. They've implemented specialized building codes, launched public education campaigns, and conducted emergency response drills. There's a tremendous effort to get communities ready. But at the end of the day, every single person in the New Madrid region must take this threat seriously and have a personal preparedness plan. Simple actions like securing your home, stocking up on supplies, identifying safe spots, and knowing what to do during an earthquake can make a world of difference. Because when that inevitable big one strikes again, lives will depend on how well prepared everyone is to withstand the unimaginable forces that will be unleashed. It's a stark reminder that despite our technological advancements, the sheer power of nature can humble us in an instant. So let's hope that the New Madrid faults remain quiet for many years to come. But let's also be prepared, just in case those faults decide to rumble back to life and maybe even cause the Mississippi River to flow backward once more. After all, it's happened before.